Good afternoon. The title of my presentation is Application of Biofertilizers in Gala Apple Orchards at Planting, Consequences in Mineral Content, Agronomic and Physiological Performance. Despite the public pressure to return to a less intensive production model, with less inputs and negative environmental and ecological effects, we clearly believe in an intensive and modern production model, reinforced with more technology, with the use of precision fruit farming tools, where farmers can be more competitive while producing safe and quality food and improving the soils and environmental balance. So we believe that one of the technologies to introduce is the use of biofertilizers. And for that, an experimental protocol was signed with the Ashfert Global, producer of biofertilizers, to analyze tree behavior after the application of biofertilizers in field conditions, getting data about biometric changes, mineral uptake, and physiological-based indicators, knowing that in field conditions with water deficit, and especially in Mediterranean climate conditions, responses can be quite different as they obtained in the lab. We also pretended to evaluate the possibility of reducing the use of fertilizers, thanks to the potential of biofertilizers, since they can improve bioavailability, interfere with root growth, and absorption efficiency, among others. And finally, we pretend to obtain additional information by performing destructive tests. To do that, a small plot of 922 square meters was planted in May 2018 with branched trees of Gala Red Lamb grafted on the M9 with 3,472 trees per hectare. And at the same time, some trees were also planted in pots for destructive tests and treated with the biofertilizers at the commercial doses. 8 rows of 40 trees were selected and have been treated with the same biofertilizers since 2018 until today. 2 control rows were left without biofertilizers, 1 fertilized with the standard program with the reference C100, and other with 70% of C100 with the reference of the C70. And both of the controls were compared with the rows treated with the biofertilizers and with 70% of mineral fertilization to analyze the possibility of reducing the use of chemical fertilizers. The effects of 3 biofertilizers were assessed, namely of Micochel in doses of 2 and 4 tablets, Ansford colored MIC2 and MIC4 with the composition presented in the screen, applied only at the plantation, so in 2018, key plantal grip in doses of 6 and 12 liters per hectare, Ansford colored AUG 6 and AUG 12, and key plant in mass in doses of 6 and 12 liters per hectare, Ansford colored in mass 6 and in mass 12, applied at the start of each of the crop cycles. Looking for some results, the application of the biofertilizers led to an increase in the leaf nitrogen content, with average values in the first two crop seasons higher than C70, and in most cases equivalent to or higher than C100. Soil phosphorus increase was faster in MIC2, MIC4, and AL12, and all the biofertilizer trees had higher leaf phosphorus content during the second year. Soil magnesium content trend to increase in biofertilizer trees, in some cases even better than C100, with the major absorption evidenced in the leaf content, with all of the biofertilizer trees having more magnesium content than C70, and in the case in mass 6, in mass 12, and AUG 6, being higher than C100. MIG2 and AL12 also promoted quicker increase in soil potassium content. And we can also say that the soil team with whom we are collaborating found an important difference in soil analysis in terms of bacteria with capacities to solubilize phosphorus, to fix atmospheric nitrogen, higher soil microbial activity, enzymes with capacity to degrade organic matter, among the others, which can explain these differences. Looking for biometric data, we can see that trunk and accumulated vegetative growth seemed to be boosted by the application of endomycorrhizae, namely MYC2 and MYC4 at plantation. Trunk cross-sectional area after the second year increased more in MYC4 in MAS12 and MYC2 above the controls. Differences from C17 mean more 6.8 kilometers of new growth formed per hectare after the second year for MYC4, more 5.7 kilometers for MYC2 and 1.6 kilometers for AL12. In the end of last year, I can say in advance that MYC4 represents 76.4 kilometers of branches per hectare against 61.9 kilometers in C17, showing the power of endomycorrhizae applied at plantation. Accumulated fruit growth during 2019 crop cycle showed a smaller increase in C17 and AL12, and a bigger increase in C100, in MAS6, in MAS12, MYC4, and MYC2. It should also be announced that MYC2, MYC4, in MAS6 and AL12 were the most productive treatments, and in some of them, fruit growth did not appear to be affected by crop load. SPAD value measured along the, both the crop cycles showed C70 with the lowest average and in MAS6 with the highest average. AL12 registered higher SPAD value than C70 in all the measurements, and we are talking about 8 measurements during 2018 and 2019. MYC4 registered SPAD values above C70 in 7 measurements, in MAS6 in 6 measurements, in MAS12 and C100 in 5 measurements, and MYC2 and ALK6 in half of the measurements. This value is related with leaf chlorophyll content and is directly associated with the efficiency and capacity of the photosynthetic apparatus. Showing some more physiological parameters, we can see that in 2019, crop cycle photosynthetic rate was higher in MAS6 and AL12, and lower in MAS12 and ALK6, with difference ranging from 13.7 to 10.8 micromole per square meter per second. Specific leaf area was consistent with these values, with MAS6 and AL12 having lower values, which means thicker leaves, and C70 and ALK6 higher values, which mean thinner leaves, resulting from the difference in carbon net assimilation. During 2018, leaves from biofertilizer trees had lower specific leaf area than C70 and close to C100. Maximum quantum yield of the photosystem II photochemistry as a sensitive indicator of plant photosynthetic performance did not seem to indicate significant disturbance in any of the treatments, since values were in the range of 0.78 to 0.81, which is the approximate optimal value for many plant species. Performance index didn't show also significant differences, ranging from 4.8 to 5.5, meaning a suitable plant overall photosynthetic performance. Analyzing 2019 yields, we can see then, apart from MAS12 and ALK6, yields were higher in biofertilizer treatments than in both controls. AL12, MYC2, MYC4, and MAS6 produced above the control with the same fertilization program, meant more 16.2, 8, 6.3, and 5.1% respectively. When production is normalized with trunk cross-sectional area, AL12 and MAS6 seems to be the most efficient. Despite the higher yields, apart from MYC2, all the biofertilizer treatments produced higher fruits than C70, but smaller and less heavy than C100. Looking for fruit quality, fruits from C17 had the highest firmness, and fruits from C100 had the lowest firmness and the worst solid soluble content. ALK12, ALK6, and INMAS12 allowed to obtain the reddest apples, as we can see by the lower U. Apart from MIG2, all the biofertilizer treatments led to higher percentage of diameters above 70 millimeters, the ones with more economic value, with MIG4, INMAS6, and INMAS12 above 40% and similar to C100. All the biofertilizer treatments had also lower percentage of fruits with less than 60 millimeters. Looking for some results of the destructive trials realized in pots, it's possible to see that non-treated plants invested more in the main root and less in the secondary and tertiary roots. In this regard, it was observed that all the trees treated with biofertilizers had a higher number of lateral roots, so more branching, with ALK6 treatment standing out with an average of 9.6 roots per plant and a total root weight of 232 grams. MIG2 and INMAS6 also presented a higher number of branches, although this was not reflected in the total height of the roots, which could mean greater investment in fine roots. In fact, segregation of the fine roots was very difficult in biofertilizer trees, thanks to very thin, abundant thickness entangled with the substrate, which does not have a relevant expression in total height, but can play a fundamental role in the absorption and soil exploitation capacity. The effect of the biofertilizers were more noticeable in the greater development of the above ground part, whereby the plants treated with the ALK6 presented the greatest total height, followed by those treated with INMAS6 and MIG2. Biofertilizer trees showed also higher trunk length, total height of the branches, and height per branch, with highest values achieved by INMAS6 with more than 2 meters of trunk length and 117 grams of total weight of the branches. INMAS6 and ALK6 treatments presented a higher number of branches than the control group. So, preliminary conclusions. We can highlight these three conclusions. Reestablish the soil-plant balance in modern fruit production models is essential to assure their success. Offsetting the negative effects caused by the reduction of organic fertilization, excessive application of herbicides, and exploitation of the productive potential necessary for the economic sustainability of the farming operations. Biofertilizers proven to be important in enhancing biological activity of the soil, with impact in plant installation and further development, allowing the formation of more robust and productive trees with fewer fertilizer units applied, increasing soil fertility and reducing soil and water contamination. Trials are ongoing and we will allow to prove the long-term benefits of the use of the biofertilizers in field conditions and in modern fruit orchards. And thanks for your attention.